Welcome back to The Breakfast Show 2. I'm here this morning with Emily Cowan and Joe Taylor from Discovery Playhouse in Cape Girardeau for Discovery Science. Good morning, guys. Thanks so much for joining us. Always so exciting to have you all. So what are we learning about? What are we doing today?
Yeah, thanks for having us. Well, today we thought we'd have a little lesson on eggs,
yeah,
specifically bird and reptile eggs. Mm-hmm. We want to talk about the differences between the two, and then we want to show people at home how they can make their own snake eggs,
yeah,
using regular old chicken eggs. Miss Cowan here is our real big animal guru, so we're hoping we can defer to her, and she can tell us a little bit more about why snake eggs have these interesting, like this soft quality to them.
Right. So, like Joey said, there are a lot of differences between snake eggs, mm-hmm, and bird eggs, or
yeah,
what we would think of the two. It's a lot of reptile eggs in general. Of course, there are exceptions to any rule, but when bird eggs come out, they actually are soft.
Oh.
But because the birds have to incubate them by sitting on them,
mm-hmm,
the eggs harden up.
Mm.
Reptile eggs, or snake eggs specifically, they stay soft because they're not incubated. Most reptiles will bury their eggs in soil,
mm-hmm,
and they need to be able to soak up moisture and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So they're incubated by the earth.
Wow.
And by their environment that they're in. So they remain pretty soft and not necessarily flexible, but pliable would,
yeah,
be the word that I would use, mm-hmm, for that. Yeah.
That's super neat. And do snake eggs or reptile eggs, do they have a different coloring, kind of like what we're seeing here? Is it more of a yellowish color?
So that's a really good question. So they actually stay pretty much the same color. They're kind of a white, creamyish color.
Uh-huh.
Bird eggs actually come in a way more variety of colors than reptile eggs do, and that's because they're more out in the open.
Oh,
bird eggs are. They're out in nests. They're more exposed to predators. So they need kind of like camouflage. So they,
mm-hmm,
come in so many different colors because they have more of a diverse environment to fit into.
Yeah.
Whereas reptile eggs are mostly buried underground. So,
mm-hmm,
they don't have any need to that evolutionary change in,
right,
color.
Who knew that there was so many different things that are about eggs? Like, I didn't really realize that a snake's egg was more pliable, mm-hmm, rather than a bird's egg. I just thought that they all were hard eggs.
Yeah.
That's,
yeah,
what you think of as an egg, just being hard. So talk a little bit about, we can make a snake egg,
mm-hmm,
at home.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we don't have access to real snake eggs,
right,
here, but everyone at home is more than welcome to try to make, mm-hmm, their own snake eggs by using regular old chicken eggs. You can get these at the grocery, mm-hmm, store. This is an incredibly simple experiment,
uh-huh,
that will allow your kids at home to investigate the properties of eggshells and also be able to get a feel of how reptile eggs feel in real life. So,
yeah,
you're just gonna need some regular old eggs,
mm-hmm,
some vinegar, and then some sort of container to put the eggs,
yeah,
and vinegar,
mm-hmm,
in. We can use like a plastic bowl or even Ziploc bags. You just,
mm-hmm,
take the eggs, put them in a container, fill them up completely, let them be submerged,
mm-hmm,
in the vinegar, and then you just wait 24 hours. And after 24 hours, the calcium shell gets dissolved,
mm-hmm,
by the vinegar because it's an acid. It gets dissolved,
right,
away. And then what you're left with is just the membrane surrounding,
mm-hmm,
the egg. And in fact, it has this really kind of interesting bouncy quality,
gosh,
to it. You can,
look at that. That is bizarre.
More than free, yeah, to take one,
mm-hmm,
of these. And they have this really interesting bouncing quality. And then during the experiment, we encourage everyone at home to consider ideas about, like, why does this work? You know, what is the relationship between the calcium and the acid inside of the vinegar? How does that work? Why are reptile eggs soft, whereas bird eggs are, you know, more fortified?
Uh-huh.
Why is that? That's a really interesting question that we're hoping the people at home can investigate and find,
yeah,
out for themselves. It's very interesting.
Mm-hmm. That is super cool. And it only takes 24 hours for it to turn into this.
Just,
yes,
24 hours, and if you wait even longer, it will become solid completely all the way through it, to the point where you can kind of chuck it and,
yeah,
bounce it like a bouncy ball.
Yeah.
It's really interesting.
That is super neat.
Yeah.
And so then, is there a way that you can kind of, like, trying to think of a way to capture this turning into, the egg turning into this, could you, I guess, over that course of 24 hours, see the shell kind of, I guess, dissolve and,
yes,
it turn into this?
Yes, it's very interesting. When,
yeah,
you pour the vinegar in, it gets all bubbly, and you can,
oh,
see the,
okay,
the calcium breaking down inside of the eggs.
I actually did not let mine soak as long as Joey did.
Yeah.
So I did 12 hours on mine.
Okay.
So you can start,
oh, yeah, you
to
can
see
tell.
It's becoming a little more translucent.
Yeah.
You can kind of see through it, and it's much
yeah, that's not
softer.
A normal egg.
Yeah, in,
yeah,
fact, this is probably even closer to what a true reptile egg would,
mm-hmm,
look like. It's still got the slight, you know,
yep,
mm-hmm, whiteness to it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And so then, does a reptile's egg have the more likelihood of, I guess, breaking because it is you know, softer. It's not that hard shell that I feel like would you know, hold the bird better? Maybe not. I don't know.
That's a really good question. No, I'm sure that a lot of people think that, but actually, no. They, with that pliability, they're able to retain their shape.
Yeah.
So because they don't have the rigid outer shell, they're very resilient.
Yeah.
So you can like poke, you know, or like poke these, and you see it's kind of retaining its shape. If I were to do that to one of these, my thumb would go right through it.
Right, exactly.
It's also important to remember that most reptile eggs are buried. Turtles oftentimes will lay their eggs, snakes oftentimes will lay their eggs underground, and they're protected by the ground itself. Mm-hmm. So, you know, even though they're softer, they're protected.
Yeah. Well, that is super neat. And I feel like this is the perfect experiment to do today, this weekend, for how hot it's going to be.
Definitely.
This is a perfect inside activity that you can have fun with. And this is super cool how it turns out into this. Well, guys, thanks so much
for
joining us.
Thank you for having us again. Appreciate it.
Yep. We'll be back in just a few minutes.